Yo, parts. Yeah, front or rear? Okay. Uh-huh. 89 Regal. Yeah. Yeah, we got them. 3281. Hey, I don't make the prices. These babies list for over $50. Well, I hope you do, too. Yo, parts. Chucky, you ugly mother. Who did you rip off yesterday? Uh-huh. Well, yours, too. What kind of car are you screwing up today, huh? Uh-huh. Okay. Yeah, well, what year model? Mm-hmm. Well, what's the engine size? Or am I going to have to read your mind, what little there is of it, huh? Eh? Okay. This magic screen here says we got two of them, but I wouldn't bet on it. Let me put an eyeball on it. Hold on. Yeah, miracle of miracles, we got two. You want one of them. Coming at you.
Barney! Barney! Barney, down here by the phone.
What the? Who are you?
I'm Gary from the phone company.
AT&T?
No, a little phone company. I was just wondering, that call you just had, was that a customer?
Yeah. Yeah, and a good customer, too. He likes for me to give him a hard time like that.
How do you know he likes it?
Parts? Wayne? No. No, he ain't here. He's at the doctor's. He's got hemorrhoids.
Who knows?
He said he'd be back by 11, but I wouldn't count on him. Sure. That was a good customer, too.
How long have you been in the parts business?
20 years. And I'm the best there is. The other parts stores in town don't have nobody who can hold a candle to me. And everybody in this town wants to talk to old Barney. Look at this. Yo, parts. Jerry? Jerry, line two. Wow. Some of them want to talk to the other dingbats around here, but that's only because the countermen suck up to them. There it goes again. Yo, parts. Uh-huh. Oh, yeah, we got plenty of them. What year model is that? Uh-huh. What engine size? Lady, all of them were four cylinders in that year. What size? Oh, the big one. Yeah. Hold on. Yeah, we got it. Let me see here. 1763. Hey, lady, you want cheap? You gotta go somewhere else. We got quality. Hey, if you want to take a chance with that engine, go down to Auto Action. Yeah, they got stuff that's just off the boat. You know, that's what burns me up. Gives me a headache. About half the calls I get. Half the calls I get are from price shoppers. And none of them ever come in and buy nothing. If she needed a filter, why the hell did she call around about price? Do you believe it? She didn't even know her engine size.
I bet her old man told her
It was the big one. I hope she buys a cheap one and blows her engine.
I know you've been in the business a long time, and that you know a lot about parts. But there are some things down the line that you need to learn. Down the line, the telephone line. Pick up the receiver and place it down here by me. I want us to go listen to some other CarQuest counter pros in action.
Oh, like wiretapping?
Not exactly.
Oh. Hey, how did you do that?
Ma Bell calls it downsizing.
What's that smell?
You're right, it smells bad. Wonder which one of the dingbats uses this phone the most.
Hey.
Let's get out of here. Hang on to your hat.
Hey, this is weird.
CarQuest Auto Parts, this is Tim.
Okay, Jerry, give me just a moment to find it here. It's a 91 Grand Marquis. Okay, 91 Grand Marquis, reman master cylinder, and power brakes, of course. Okay.
Hey, did you notice how pleasantly he answered that call? And how he identified himself so the customer would know who he was talking to?
All my customers know me.
Everybody knows you?
Yeah.
I'll agree that your regular customers know the sound of your voice. And no doubt these are regular customers of Tim's, because he's calling them by name. But how do you know, before you pick up the phone, that it's someone that knows you?
Jerry, yes, we have it. Please remind your customer has a full 36,000-mile warranty, and the list price is $105.83, with your cost only being $52.91. And Jerry, you know your customer, so you may want to mention that the lifetime warranty new master cylinder is only about $10 more, with your cost only $5 more, and we have both of them. Sure will. We'll be there in about half an hour. And Jerry, thanks for calling us.
Oh, yeah, like, what is this, a movie? Like, if this was real life, his customers must be a bunch of wimps, my customers. They would run a counterman right out of town if he was that nice.
So, Barney, what you're saying is your business philosophy is that customers, people with money and a choice where to spend it, will choose to spend it with people that treat them rudely, people that don't offer additional information, people that don't treat them in a professional manner, and people that never say thank you? Have I got that correct, Bob?
No, that's not exactly what I said. But at our store, we're busy, and then it's different when the real...
Speaking of busy, let's get to our next phone call before we get a busy signal.
Another.
Thank you for calling CarQuest Auto Parts. This is John. Skip, you're needing a muffler for a 91 LeBaron, 2.5, no turbo. May I put you on hold for a minute? I'll be right back. Thanks. Thank you for calling CarQuest Auto Parts. This is John. Jack, I'm sure we've got it. All right, I'll send it right down. Is there anything else you need on this trip? Okay. And thanks for calling us. Skip? Thanks for holding. The muffler is a 10-28-12. And we've got it. According to the diagram, it's got a metal tang welded on the back. Can we send it on down? Thanks, Skip. One more thing. Have you been under the car? How's that rear hanger look? Okay. We'll be down with just the muffler. Thanks again for calling us.
Did you see how he handled those two calls? And how he asked the first customer if he could put him on hold?
Oh, sure, like you have time to do this in the real world.
Hey, the parts business is the real world. Look, 10 seconds to repeat back the information the customer gave him, plus ask him to hold, and waited for a response from the customer. Did you also notice how he restarted the conversation with Skip?
No.
He called him by name, thanked him for holding, and then started giving him information about the part. He took care of the person first, and then the business. Let's go see some more professionals doing business.
Okay.
Thanks for calling CarQuest Auto Parts. This is Sam.
Sam? Where's my water pump? I called an hour and a half ago. Let me speak to Larry.
Is this Burley?
Yeah, you're killing me. I've been waiting all morning.
Okay, Burley, I understand you're upset, and I understand why. First off, let me tell you, though, that Larry is not in the store right now. Did you order the part from Larry?
No, the new kid, Dave. You know, the one with the personality like a turtle?
Okay, Burley, you ordered the pump about 90 minutes ago from Dave. Uh-huh. Okay, now, Burley, so that I can track it down and see what happened, I need to know the type of vehicle the pump was for.
An old 88 Honda Accord.
Okay, Burley, can I get you to hold on for just 1 minute while I run back and look at the delivery table and also check with Dave? Is that all right, Burley? All right.
This is real life. I got 100 customers just like that beauty. I got guys so mean that they would tear the throat out of a Doberman and use it for a drinking straw.
You certainly have a way with words.
Burley, thanks for holding. Yeah, I've got some information that helps explain the delay in getting that part to you. Now, we didn't have the part. We stock it, but we're out. Dave thought he told you that we were going to have to try to find the part in one of our other stores. Did he mention that?
Yeah. He told me to send somebody over to the South store to pick it up. But he didn't tell me it'd take them all morning.
Okay. Dave billed the pump at 10:53 while he was talking to you. Now, when our driver got to the South store, they didn't have it. And she called back and told Dave. Dave did locate one for you at the West End store. So he sent Diane all the way out to the West End store to pick it up. And Diane left the West End store about 20 minutes ago. And you're the only stop on her route, so she should be getting to you pretty soon.
Well, why didn't somebody call and tell me all this?
Burley, you're right. Now, that's where we dropped the ball. We should have called you to let you know the status of the part. Now, Dave was on top of the situation. He and Diane, along with the help of our other store managers, were doing everything possible to get that part to you as quickly as possible. Now, we appreciate your business, Burley. We need your business, and we're not trying to mess up your day. We were trying to do what was right, but we screwed up, and we should have called to keep you posted. And for that, we are sorry.
Sam, here she comes now, Sam. Hey, sorry I blasted you like that.
I'll bet you defuse your customers just like that.
Most of my customers are sorry, but I don't tell them about it.
I'm sorry we can't stay any longer. We have to make a long-distance call.
Here we go.
In making your decision, you might want to consider our CarQuest coast-to-coast warranty. Please excuse me a moment while I answer this phone. I'll be right back, okay? Thank you for calling CarQuest Auto Parts. This is Dan.
Do you have, and how much is a set of spark plug wires for a 1988 Chevrolet pickup with 305 engine?
Spark plug wires for a 1988 Chevrolet pickup 305 engine? Yes, we have a set. They're only $21.95. They have a 50,000-mile warranty or 5 years. This is a quality set of wires that will provide you with years of trouble-free service. Does our price seem competitive with comparable quality wires you've priced?
Yes, it does. A little higher than a couple, but less than most.
Our store is conveniently located on Pittman Avenue. We're one block south of Main on the right-hand side of the street, directly across the street from Kentucky Fried Chicken. Are you familiar with this area of town?
Yes, we are.
Great. I hope you choose to come to us for your spark plug wires. We're open till 6 p.m. tonight and every night. My name is Dan. Is there anything else I could help you with today?
No, thank you, but we'll probably see you later.
Great. Thanks for calling CarQuest.
Do you think she will come in and buy that wire set?
Maybe. Okay, probably.
Do you remember what you told me about telephone price shoppers?
No.
Well, let's see.
Hey, lady. Lady, if you want cheap, go somewhere else. We got quality. Hey, you want to take a chance on your engine? Go down to Auto Action. They got stuff that's just off the boat. You know, that's what burns me up. Gives me a headache. About half the calls I get. Half the calls I get
are from price shoppers. And none of them ever come in and buy nothing.
Well, yeah, I suppose what a guy hears on the other side of the phone might affect their opinion of the store.
Not just their opinion about the store, but their opinion about you. You are the most important part of the parts business. Are you ready to go home?
Yeah.
Well, before we go, I need to fill out a call report. Here's a notebook.
Wow. That's some piece of paper. Yeah.
All right, your full name was what?
Wait a minute. My goodness. This is just between you and me?
Yeah, sure, just between you and me.
Bernard Alphonse D'Amato. A small A.
Well, maybe I'll send you a monogram shirt. That's B-A-D.
Yeah, that... I ain't ever eaten any more of those breakfast burritos.